Hi folks, thanks as always for joining me. This is Sutton Park, this one from a photograph. I'll show you in a minute.
I'll just quickly mention both books. Volume 2 of my book is available now on Amazon in print. Still waiting for the Kindle version to get sorted. So let me show you the photograph I used for this one in Sutton Park.
So I was sort of stood, it's only a narrow little stream that ran through there, it might even have been flooded that section, I'm not quite sure where it came from, but made for a nice composition. So let me show you the colours that I used. My palette, as always, we got ultramarine, lemon yellow, Payne's grey, alizarin crimson, raw sienna, burnt umber and light red, and I used a large Ron Ranson Ake number 3 rigger and then a little rigger as well. So starting off with just clear water, then I'm gonna take just a little bit of blue, bit of sky up there, some down there, then I'm gonna put a raw sienna and a bit more of that blue, I think. And it's like a, don't worry about all the water dripping down the page. It's just sort of abstract background that's coming all the way across to where the grass is starting, about somewhere around there. Something like that. And a whole load of, it's a bit too wet at the moment, so it's actually scraping. See, it's just filling straight back in. Darker bits here and there. While I'm just wiping that to dry a little bit, let's just start putting a little bit of that grass below it. I'm starting off just over there. Put the grass down there. There's no water over there. So the sort of water, it starts about there. In fact, if I just get the shape of that water, so it sort of snakes, sort of stops about there. Just trying to look. I've always got the light reflection off the screen on the laptop. It's always, whenever the sun's out, it's a pain. Sort of coming down there like that. It's on the brush. I'm just going to work out the rest of this stream. So it's coming down to about there. That's like the main shape of it. Bit of mud mixed in amongst it all. Brown, bit of blue. Get that variation in. Watch that water dripping, accumulating at the bottom. Put in those white bits. Right, then back to this background there. A bit more abstract.
So again, here now, well, distant layer, they look miles and miles away, and it's slightly closer. I'm sort of dabbing at the colours like that. Just so you can see, I've got loads of different colours on the end of the brush, and all mixed together nicely on the paper. There you can see. See, I'm scraping there. Again, it was a dull day, so very little way of shadows, so I'm going to have to make them up again. I must get out more when the sun's out of him. This is quite a wide one, that one is. Just slightly lost track of the actually goes all the way up to the head of the water. Well, I'm gonna worry about it now, I don't think. So sort of bring it down slightly. And light red in there, just to vary that a little bit. Can't resist the odd little rock. I shouldn't overdo too many rocks. I've done a lot of scraping with the for the trees, so I'm going to resist the rocks for a minute. Let's just make sure that's flat. Clean the brush. I'm going to get back to that lemon yellow. Pushing it right up to these darker areas there. Mix this together. I've lost the, yeah, like I say, that water goes more up there, but I'm going to worry about it now. Sienna mixed together. It's like in a minute, I'm going to get to the rig and start whacking in a load of trees and branches. That's quite dark down there. Let's darken that up. A little reflection as well. Red mixed in. A lot of leaves and things on there. Just trying to do it in a sort of abstract way. Bit of ultramarine there, always good to use for the darkening. Grass right there. Right, let's get the vegan and put a few more trees in amongst all the lighter ones that I've scraped out. So I'm number 3 rig, a bit of brown, a bit of blue. mix a few darker ones in there. Right, let's get some bigger ones there now. Few reflections as well in all these. This water. That's a bigger one there. I'll do it up there like that. Things growing up there. So I might do it. I'd like to have that water, a bit of brown, a bit of blue, a bit of green. I'm just going to put that back in, I think. I'm just going to see what it looks like. Edges slightly, just define the edge of those banks. I say banks, it's only a tiny little stream. I'm just looking for a little bit of definition. Big tree there. Now it is white, I'm just wondering. Let's just get this flat again. I may as well try and do it white. It's too easy to put it in black. So first. With a bit of lemon yellow. And again, I'm just trying to get lots of colour variation in there. It's like representing all the grass and the leaves. A few mixed amongst those dark areas as well. It's difficult to resist. So resist scraping these rocks, just can't resist trying. Just trying to keep it as subtle as I can. another card. Just have a little rock here and there. Just a little bit more of this yellow, just scattered about. Right, it's, I'm going to put this, there's a big tree here, but it's white. So, right, let's put this in first. Right. So big one just there. So I was going to put it in dark. I always do that. So let's try and do it as it is in the reference photograph. So I'm going to try and put it in nice and light. Just drop me card. So I've just got a clean damp brush. I'm just going to take the powder. I'm not quite sure what it's going to look like yet, but we'll see. So it's going to. Cutting something like this. I'll take two or three attempts to get this right. Let's just redo that. Have to keep cleaning the brush, get the paint off that's took off the paper, sharpen the other edge up a bit. Another right angle. Dark on that one side. Little rings around. I can't quite sure what sort of tree you call that. But slightly more dark sections, bit of brown, bit of red, bit of blue. Yes. A little bit darker. A little bit darker. some of these. Down the base of there. Stick a few little grasses up there just at the base of this tree. Looking over into the water, and I think just need a figure. I've got a figure somewhere in the distance. I have to give it a good dry first. I'm going to put him right over there in the distance. I don't know how well he's going to show up. Little dog behind him. Finish it off. I'll stick a little bird up there. Switch to the other rigger brush, and then last but not least, put my name in, and we'll call that one finished. So. Let's stick a mains on it and see what it looks like.
So here's the painting, the main. So if we have a look at the photograph that I was using, I've not changed the elements around much. It's a shame there just weren't a few more sort of shadows to sort of play around with. But starting off with the most distant objects, you can just about see the trees slightly, but they're putting a sort of light, very light tone. Now they'll contrast against these ones, which are a lot closer to us, but a little bit darker, more prominent. And I've scraped in a few trunks here and there using the fingernail. Bit of rigger work as well, stick a few more trunks in to contrast against the lighter ones. You also get this nice effect. It looks like the light's catching the right hand side and the left hand side's in shadow, if you look at it closely. Added a few darks and shadows around the base of these trees and in the woodland area. I've tried to vary this sort of grassland section coming towards the banks as much as I could, keep it interesting. Again, plenty of variation, scraping out a few grasses with the rigger brush as well. And then you can see where I took this tree out, this light coloured tree in the foreground here, with a big eight brush. Brushed a little bit of colour and shadow on the other side of it. Just see our little man and the dog in the distance there. So that's it for this one. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoy that. Remember the books are on Amazon, paintings are on eBay. Incidentally, the reference photographs for these you'll find on Patreon if you ever want to look at those as well. So, till next time, thanks for watching. Keep practicing. Any questions, please ask, and I'll see you again soon.